Hi there, in this video I'm going to explain how you can measure an Apache Cordova app with Matomo Analytics and Matomo Tag Manager in particular. So an Apache Cordova app is nothing more at the end of the day than a website. So here what I did is that I copy and paste the Matomo Tag Manager script that you can see within the head, which is over here, the Matomo Tag Manager script. And then I define within Matomo Tag Manager the different combinations. So what I did is this. I have so two tags. One is for the home screen and the other one is in order to collect the result. So if I look at the Matomo Analytics home screen, what it is about, it's a custom HTML tag. So the reason why it's a custom HTML tag and not the basic tag offered by Matomo Tag Manager is that the basic tag of Matomo Tag Manager does not have all the features that I need. It doesn't have the possibility to count a new visit every time that someone's going to interact with the website. So that's why I needed to edit those two lines, which were not available in the basic tracking code. And I needed as well to add the set document title and set custom URL. And of course, I needed to add this within custom HTML code. So that's why I decided to make it like this. This one is fired every time that the URL contains the word localhost 2.8000, which correspond to the home screen. And then I have a second tag, which in fact is not fired on the page of result, but which is fired when there is the interaction. So in my case, it's a page view tracking code, which is fired when someone's going to click on one of the smiley. And in fact, I have a Matomo configuration which is kind of specific. So this is what I can show you up here, satisfaction. And I added in fact a custom dimension which is a one and a satisfaction. And in fact, those data are just taken out directly from here. So I added within the source code of my page, as you can see here, MTM push. So it means it's going to push a variable to the data layer, and this variable is named satisfaction. Take the value very bad. Here it will take the value bad if I click on this given element, and so on. So in fact, I'm populating the data layer with those data when someone is going to click on it. And what I did up on the other side is that I created a data layer that you can see. That you can see here. Okay, so data layer, I click here on create a new variable and I created a data layer. Okay, so this is how I did it. So now I can in fact double check it. So I can just go on this page, just refresh it. I just go over here. I'm gonna look at the, I'm gonna look at the visitor. So here, as you can see, I'm on the home screen, and what's gonna happen is that if I click on let's take this one, just the bad one. Okay, bad one is good to thank you very much for your feedback. Okay, and if I go over here and I refresh my page, I should get the bad one. So let's see how it goes. You see satisfaction bad. The reason why it happens here, you see it's an isolate one, is because I refreshed the page directly and I did not interact with it. But just to let you know that when it's installed, when it's on a tablet, when it's in a physical store, people won't have the possibility to refresh the screen. So all your visits will be like this in two. So I can in fact double check that. So I'm just gonna wait the delay of 50 seconds that I set for this given page. This is what you can investigate and see. Over here, anyway, the 50 seconds just passed. And here, if I click here on very bad, you will see that it's gonna create, in any cases, my second visit with all those actions. So the two actions, and I'm considered as a new one. And that's it for the video of today. So I really hope that you appreciate it. And in order to start exercise yourself, try to install Matomo Analytics on the Cordova Apache app and try to measure things. Once more, thanks for watching and do not hesitate to create your own videos.